this up and working. In doing so, I booted my computer and waited and waited and waited. And about 5 minutes into the wait, it was actually booted and I could move the mouse around and yeah.
Here is the computer and right here I have a normal PDF text file. It's 33.8 kilos. I just double clicked on it. I think I have to reinstall this computer. No! What do you know? It's opening a PDF file. Who would have guessed? This is, it's a script for a movie, so it's plain text. There's no pictures, there's no nothing, it's plain text. And when I opened the things for the 3D printer, they were like 150 megabytes and it took a while, so fuck that. I'm gonna reinstall this.
The 3D printer is almost ready. I have some problem. I'm not able to raise the, move the printer thing up and down, and I wanted to find out if there's, if I was doing something wrong or if the software I installed wasn't the right or if I haven't configured it right. And yeah, working on the 3D printer again. I have reinstalled the computer, installed brand new Windows 7 on it on a solid state drive this time. There was a regular SATA hard drive that was in there and I've took that out and put in a solid state drive, and now it's just marvelous and fast to work with. Subscriber here on YouTube posted me a link to the drivers and the manual and everything, the whole bundle of things in English. I think it's kind of the Chinese thing and some of it has been translated, and also other new things has been created. There's like a very good picture of where all the cables and stuff on the controller board and stuff like that. So I've been looking at that. Right now I'm about to install the programs again, the USB drivers, 3D printing program that's gonna communicate with the printer. Working on getting those installed in the right order again.
So I've been working on the printer for a couple of hours and right now I have connection to it. Again, after reinstalling the computer, and something to remember, always up here, printer settings. The communication baud rate for this model is 250,000. Mine is COM4 and down here the cast size was 63, but right now I have a good connection. And manual control over here says that the printer is idle and I can move it forth and back. Bed. And I've also heated up the plate up to 60 degrees and I've heated up the extruder to what is it set to? It's set to 150 degrees Celsius right there. One thing I'm having a lot of problem with is the set axle, this one. And if we just look at the printer and I press that, that's about it. It says click and then it totally dies. I can press whatever I want over here. Here's the mouse and clicking up and down, and that doesn't work. This one works. That's the X axle. The Y axle. Set axle is absolutely dead. I have no idea. I can control this engine as well. So I don't know what's wrong there. Right now the display up here, it thinks that the Z axle has moved. I guess it doesn't have no idea where it is.
Well, I was just sitting down here in my comfy man cave, and I just got a message, and I had asked on another YouTube video about the 3D printer and why my Z axle was not moving the printer up and down. And I have to ask this guy, this, I have no idea where he's from, but he had a nice video on YouTube. Just gonna zoom a bit in. And the guy is, I have no idea how to pronounce this. I thought that it might be Russian, so this is how Google Translate says it in Russian.
All these storms.
I think that's probably his name.
All these storms.
But he had this video where he was playing with the exact same printer. And down here I asked him, though he made some comment about the set axle stepper motor instructions incomplete, and I asked him, I'm having problems with the set axle stepper motor, they're not really moving, just says click and dies until the printer is rebooted, do you know anything? And he posted me a link to a video, and I thought, okay, someone else has made a video, but when I entered the video, it was the same guy. And now you should just see what he made.
Hi, Martin.
That's so cool.
It seems you have the same problem that I had. 3D printer have not exactly right Z-axis stepper motors.
So
wires.
Apparently the bloody cable is wrong. Cool. That's a great piece of information. It means that I don't have to send the whole bloody thing back to China. Haha, let's go do that. Well, this is the wire mess on my printer. And down here is the cable that goes into one of the Z-axle motors that is on the other side, right down there. And it's a real hassle to get that plug out of there. So what I thought I could do was just change the plug, all the plugs up here instead. One for the X axle, one for the Y axle, one for an extruder, and two for the Z axle, because there's two engines that drives that one. So I saw on the video that it was the red and the green that has to be changed. The red and the green wire has to change places, and the red wire that stays red to this end, and the green wire, this one, becomes white, and it's the same on both of them. So instead of taking the printer apart where the engine is, I think I'm just gonna swap it down here. Now I just need to find a needle. Maybe I can use this little screwdriver. Red one is out. Yeah, I got it out with a bit of violence and put it back in on the other side, and then the red one on this side. So that's gonna be very interesting. I'm gonna do the same thing with the other one. Cool. Very excited to see this, if this helps my problem. I put back in the plugs, turn on the printer, turn on the computer here. That's the program. And we're gonna connect up here.
And it's gonna connect down here, and we're gonna get some temperature there, temperature, and we're gonna go to manual control and expand that so we can see some more. That's it, and we're gonna test the other ones to make sure that they still work. That works. Back again, and yeah, that works too. Oh yeah! Oh, it moves up. Nice. Very quiet. And it moves down again. That's sweet. Now I can start adjusting this thing. Cool. I've been playing around with this for a couple of days and I am getting progress here. After that I had help changing the direction on the motors here, on the ZC axle, that has been working really well. And just to show that, we'll just move it up a bit. And it moves up. And that is pretty cool. But I thought, of course, now that that works, I'll be able to print something. And the first thing I did, I followed the instructions I've received in English instructions. Somebody has done all the hard work of translating the Chinese into English. So I think I have the PDF. Yeah, I have the PDF here, and there's like a lot of instructions. Here we are, and I was following that, and I was trying to print, and the yeah, everything went wrong. It ran out and it said tick 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 tick, like the motors was running, and the small switches, like here is a little switch, here is a little switch that is supposed to stop the set axle when the printer head is moving down, and that didn't work. The X axle worked, like this little one, that, oh, point, that, this one was working. The Y axle down here was not working either, on the back side of it. It's right down here. Where are we? There. And that's supposed to stop the printer when the printing mount here moves backwards. And I found the mistake, and it was kind of irritating because I thought actually the switch might be broken. So I took a multimeter and I thought that I was gonna measure the switch here and see if it shut on and off. And I attached a couple of needles and put it in the switch, and the switch didn't work. That was really weird. But on the board, on the controller board down here, I had of course taken out the switch that was the set axle on the board, and it turned out that I put the Y axle in the set axle and opposite, so they were not working. And as soon as I traded them around, everything was working really great. And here we have the program. Now you can actually press these home buttons without everything falling apart. So if you press the set, and we'll just try that again, X axle home, and it just touches the switch, and just try it again, and X axle home, yeah, it touches the switch, goes out and goes back to the switch. And the same thing is true with the Y axle. If we press the Y axle home right there, the the surface printing thing moves back. We can just move it a bit again. That one. And just press the home. And it goes home. And of course the last axle, the set axle. Let's just move that up a bit. It takes a while. And press the set axle home. And it moves. And it's supposed to hit that switch down there. Switch. And I'll press the home. But that works pretty well now. Well, so when that was done, I thought, now I can print. And sure, I loaded the program. There was a little test program, and you had to do a lot of stuff. And the program loaded, and the printer moved in the middle of the board and started printing, and there was no plastic coming out of it. And as you can see, plastic has come out of it, because I've been messing around with this. So I took it apart, and that's why this one is just laying on top of it. I'm not gonna print anything with this laying here and this disassembled. This is only for filming. I just thought that it was funnier to show it when it was on. Inside of the extruder, I found a piece of plastic. This little piece of plastic was sitting right there. And I thought, at first I thought, oh, the bloody Chinese that put in a piece of plastic for this to not work. They're like teasing me or something like that. And the yellow plastic is supposed to go through that and down here. And of course, when that plastic was sitting there, oh, where are my finger there? When that piece of plastic was sitting there, it was just trying to push forth and back the white piece of plastic, and that wasn't working at all. What I found out is that piece of plastic really needs to in this tube down here, so that the plastic is not heated. It's insulated from the rest until it gets into the heat block down here. This one, where the plastic is heated. But doing my many attempts, that piece of plastic has like swapped up from down there and had come up and was now blocking everything. So I took it out because I didn't know what it was, so I took it out. Luckily, I didn't throw it out. I really was thinking about that, throwing that piece of plastic out, because it didn't really help anything. So I tried to use the printer without that, and that helped a bit. Then suddenly plastic was coming out of the printer, but very fast. It kind of cocked up and did something like this. Can you see that? And it appears that now that piece of plastic was missing. The yellow plastic was not behaving as it should. So I have to put that down there again somehow to get this working correctly. And then I hope I can be printing. Another thing I've been working a lot with is when I was messing around with the home button and the printer came to this position, I don't know how to offset it, because this switch is so far down, and earlier the heat bed was higher, so I had to lower that pretty a lot actually, and still, so that now if it's too high, the print head will hit it. Right now it's really at the bottom, so I lowered the bed so much that the print head was able to go out there. And that really takes a long time to make all those adjustments, move the bed forth and back and moving it a tiny bit up and down, and making sure with the little paper test that a piece of paper slides under the print head with very little resistance all over the bed. And I lowered it so much that these screws down here were too long and they were hitting this bottom thing. So I had to replace those screws with some that was shorter. And well, everything takes time, and now I'll turn it off again and I'll see if I can get that piece of plastic down there where it's supposed to be, and hopefully that'll be good. I might have to order a new piece of plastic for that.
I just took the nozzle little tap here off, and I found out that there's plastic in here that hasn't melted, and I think I need to get that out before I can get the white piece of plastic or Teflon in there. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna heat this block up on the computer over here. Just turn that on, and before it gets up to heat, I'm gonna pour it very quietly out of there. So when the temperature reaches, right now it's 76 degrees Celsius, expect that I will be able to pour it out when it becomes a bit warmer. Now it's about 120. Yeah, it's really soft now. I think I got most of it off, so I'm gonna try and see if I can get this down. I think I'm gonna do it while it's hot. I want there's a good side of it. This one is not as broken. This one has seen a lot of wear and tear, and I want this piece up. I don't really know how far this is supposed to go down, so I'm just pulling it as far as I can. I have assembled it again. And right now I'm heating the extruder. Over here at the program, I'm loading a file that I've prepared, the Ultimaker robot. I guess it's from the Ultimaker 3D printer program something. I'm loading that little robot there. I want that to be the first print that I'm gonna do. Right now I'm heating up the bed and the extruder, and I'm gonna see if I can get some plastic to run through this. There it is. See, the plastic is coming out of the nozzle down here. Well, this is the first print ever. It doesn't look very good. It's not pretty. It's not really taking the plastic through very good. But, well, it did put something on it for once, so can't really complain about that. It's printing! Woohoo! Oh, and it just broke up, so I guess this job is over. Okay, it did something. I'm gonna stop it. Over here at the computer. Kill job. So, my first 3D print ever. Totally ruined. It just fell off. It wasn't connected good enough to the plate. But I'm definitely gonna start this over and see if I can do better than this. So the printer is finally doing something. It's not perfect yet. It's just started a new run. I just started it again. I have to see if I can do better than this. But definitely bucky to start with. It's a lot of work and a lot of problems, and I did a lot of stupid mistakes too.
don't think you can do it over a couple of days. It takes longer than that, and it takes a lot of finding information on the internet and asking people. Thank you for watching my videos. Do subscribe to my channel and leave your comments below. Have a nice day.